Hey guys, MonkDraft here, and today I'm going to be showing you how to make a thing that will help you travel a bit faster. Today I'm going to be showing you how to make the powered rail generator. Now, this is a glitch in the game which hasn't been fixed yet, and I've tested out with the new snapshots as well, and it seems to be working fine in those as well. So we can safely assume that 1.3, this is still going to be able to be done in 1.3. So, without further ado, this is what basically it does. When you flip this lever here, it sends a one makes this do a one pulse tick, which goes into these pistons here and makes these go back and forth. Now, during this glitch, if I hold this on for, let's count to, let's say 15 seconds. So, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. 11, 12, 13, 14, 15. Okay, so 15 seconds thereabouts. And let's see how many we've got here. Okay, so in 15 seconds we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 full stacks and a stack of 46. In 15 seconds. I don't even think you need this is like an extended. Quite eccentric one as well. I mean, unless you're planning to do like powered rails on a full track around the whole map, you probably won't need something to this extent. But you know, if you've got a server, maybe it works on servers as well. But if you've got, I find it works on vanilla servers more than bucket servers. I'm not sure what the issue is there, but I've had two bucket servers, especially my Let's Play server, where it doesn't work too well, but it has worked on vanilla servers 100% every time. So, but yeah, unless you have like maybe a lot of people, and this is gonna be like in the town maybe on your server, and you want to kind of create some things for everyone to play on, so everyone has a rail, a powered rail generator, then this is perfect for them. Otherwise, you can make a smaller one, maybe just two pistons or maybe just one. So, if we just get rid of these, because we're not exactly gonna need them, and I will take you through the process. So, if we look at here, now this is the standard way of making a one tick pulse. It's not the easiest and it's not the nicest, to be honest. I see if I can make this work, because the idea is you have to break and put redstone down. Sorry, redstone. You have to do like so quickly to make it work, so it'll be that and there you go. And then when you add it to that, you get your rails. So there we go. But as I say, this is, I mean, that happened pretty much third time or first time with the rest of them. But it can take quite a long time depending on how quickly you can click the mouse and all that stuff. So it's not exactly reliable. Plus, as you saw when I came over to it, it was on the on state, and that was just due to a glitch from leaving and then coming back. So if you're on a server, that's not going to be great. And if you're on single player as well, it's not going to be that great. So the other option would be to have it, plus you want to on off, sorry. So if you wanted an on off system, you would have to maybe do a lever with a piston to create your on off system. Once again though, you're still having the problem of having to have the tick, and if it goes off and stays or stays on, or it just screws up in any way, shape, form, you're gonna have to break and then put something down really quickly. So if I did that and then, oh, is it? No, it's that. Nope, it's not. I can't remember how you do it now. It's that and then break place. Nope. See, it has to be really quickly. Break place. There you go. So, still, you know, it has the on-off ability, but it's using this, which is still rather rubbish. Now, this is the one that I usually use, and it's my personal favorite. It uses the piston. It stays on one tick here and zero ticks here, or at least no, it's two and one even. That means that the piston stays closed for just one tick, while this sends one pulse through here, and then when you pull it out, as you'll see, it creates a circuit, goes around the wood, into the wood, and just keeps doing that over and over again. And then I hooked it up to the piston, which gives me my rails like so. So I'll just turn it off. Now I do love this design. It's one I use for all my one tick generators. But in a recent video by Kuehl Palmstairs, new series Sharing is Caring, he found a subscriber of his gave him this idea, this design, uses two less, sorry, three less repeaters, and is a little bit more compact. So if I look at there, that's my edge of the other one, and it uses two less spaces. So it's a little bit more compact in two spaces, and width-wise, it's insanely compact. It's only three wide, and this is one, two, three, four. Oh, sorry, it's only one difference. But yeah, it looks different though. It looks more. So same principle again, though. This one has it turned on, and then when you turn it off, it's still one tick here that closes and creates a pulse. So we just do that. You get the pulse and the one tick pulse, and it creates your rails like so. Now, this design of the rail generator is fun. It's a really good design, and everything that works beautifully, but it depends on your orientation. So if we just come up to this one here, the main one, if you wanted it so that you wanted all the pistons nice and stuck together like that, with no spaces in between, you would need to place it, the pistons, either in the F1 or F3. You can find this out by going into your F3 menu, and if I go into there, you'll see here, if you look at my mouse, it's F3, and if I turn around, same place is F1, and if I go to that way, it's 0, and if I do that side, it's 2. So always be sure if you want it flush with each other, it needs to be F1 or F3. So there's a little bit of information that you'd have to remember. If you wanted it in the other orientations, you would need to put a space between them. Now the reason for this is that it has a for this design to be in this orientation, you need to have a powered rail between the pistons at each one of the spots. Otherwise, when if you don't have them there, I'll just take these away. You turn it on, you won't get anything. It's a small glitch, but it's just the orientation. So if you put one there though, there, there. I don't think you need to actually put it there, you could just put it there and there. Yeah, so you just put one between the two and you'll get your powered rails. So, worth remembering that orientation is dependent on this, so be sure to have it in the right orientation to make it work. So now we've discussed, now we've gone over that, we'll go into making it. So I'll just get rid of this stuff I don't need. I wish it was in the snapshot, just hold shift, it's easier. There we go. And if you go to here, these are the things you'll need. So you will need some repeaters. I'm not sure how many, but you'll need repeaters. Redstone is all dependent on how many you make anyway. A lever, some torches or a torch, some powered rails, at least two, or depending on the design. So it's at least three, depending on design. A wooden block, so a sticky piston. And a decoration block of your choice. I'm just going to go with that one. So, since we want to make it nice and flush for this design, well, we'll do it right here. Okay. So, let's go a bit further back so you have it nice and flush because I like things symmetrical. So, we'll do the one that Cubehamster designed, Sharing is Caring, came up with because it's actually a really good design and it's rather compact, as I say, and quite simple. So, you just put your piston, your block, your another block, and then a torch. Then you put repeater facing that way, facing that way, bit of redstone, and you're done. And oh, and a lever like that, and you're done. That's your circuit set up for the one tick pulse. It's really quick and easy, really simple to make. So now you take a power from either this side or that side. It's totally up to you, but depending on what state you want the pistons in, I'd take it from this side personally because that way it'll be on the off state all the time until you turn it on. So we'll just go down here, like so, and then get your repeaters and just make a line of them like this. And I think it goes up to 10, so you want 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. We'll go with 9. Just be on the safe side. So then, just put your pistons in front of them like this, and then your powered rails. Just put two like that, like that. That's it. You're done. If you turn this on now, you should get an infinite supply of powered rails. Oh, maybe not. Of course you would if you actually connected it. A little bit of a mistake there, sorry. So we just connect this like this, and now you're done. So now if we turn it on, there we go. That's a bit more like it. So now you'll just get an infinite supply of power drills. Just turn it off. Now, as I say, if you were doing it in the other orientation, you would all you'd have to do is remove two of these, like so, and remove the pistons in between like that, and then just put a power rail there, there, and there. Just so you have one power rail. So it's one power rail for two lines. So because it's uneven. In fact, if I go take that one away, put that there, take that one away, and I think another one should work. We shall try. So there we do that. Put that one there. So now, yeah, okay, it works. So now it'll do the two. But as I say, you need one power drill in between each two. So in between those two, one. In between those two, one. In between those two, one. And that'll work perfectly, and you'll get all your power drills. Then after that, it's just basically decoration. So you know, just make it look pretty and whatnot. I try to make it look like a little bit of a station since it was going to be for powered rails for train tracks. So yeah, and then do that. And of course, since you're going to be whatnot wanting the holes in the middle, just cover those like that. And maybe put like some on the floor. Make it look a little bit more tidier. Oh, a bit there. And there we go. So yeah, totally up to you how you want to design it though. I've just messed up a little bit there. We'll just put that like that. My OCD, I need everything to be symmetrical. There we go. sorry about that, had a coughing fit. So if you want to make the button around the front like I did on this design, that's just a simple case of putting that there, and I'm sure you all you know how to set up a button, so just bring the wire down like that. Not there. And bring it back around like that. Put a repeater. Because this isn't going to be long enough, you put another repeater round about there. And that should be okay. We turn it on now. There we go. So it's still working even with two repeaters because at the end of the day, the power isn't coming from these, it's coming from this. So yeah. I hope you enjoyed this, guys. I hope you found it useful. If you do, be sure to give that like button some love. I've got a bit of a glitch with Optifine, I think, there. I think that's Optifine. Yep, it's there. So yeah, if you did find this tutorial useful, be sure to give that like button some love. I really appreciate it. Also, if you haven't subscribed and you feel like these sort of tutorials are going to be helpful to you in your Minecrafting adventure, then be sure to give me some subscribe as well. I'd be really appreciate it as well. And of course, if you think that people will enjoy these tutorials, be sure to share them and spread the word. And until next time, guys, I think that's going to be it. So peace out, TTYL, and bye bye. Bye bye. So many powered rails. Rails. Rails everywhere. Bye.